Okay, so here's the drive motor off the rear suspension of the BMW. See if I can get inside this. The gear here is riveted together. It looks like pop rivets, actually, which seems a bit how you're doing, but still, I guess if it works, it works. Okay, sure enough, a conventional worm gear. That actually looks to be part of the armature. That's quite neat. There's a kind of a bayonet arrangement, looks of it. As if this just rotates a few degrees and then our lock will come out. Oop, some kind of spring holding it. Oh, it's just the magnet, okay. Oh, very neat. Nice little permanent magnet motor. It's brushed though, which is surprising. So the question is, what do these two signal wires do? Maybe they just count pulses. That would make sense, wouldn't it? That way, that would explain why the system needs calibrating. If it's just measuring revs, then it needs to calibrate itself to know where the extremes of movement are, and then count the number of revolutions from there to each position. So nice and simple. Yeah, it looks as if these two wires, the brown and the green, go onto a little PCB inside this plastic housing, which, I mean, there is a commutator, so I presume it's brushed. Let's try and get this bearing off. Okay, so here we go. The brushes are, there we go. So, yeah, off the end of the armature, sure enough, brushes, brush DC motor, just straightforward. But on this side, it looks like a Hall effect sensor. Looking at it in more detail, yeah, it's pretty straightforward, I think. There's a on the end of this armature, there's actually a magnet here, ring ferrite magnet, which I've managed to break, but nevertheless, so that'll be spinning around with the armature. And on this small PCB, there's a Hall effect sensor there, just sat there, and some kind of signal conditioning going on. On here, there's a stack of passive components on there, and something there, a little black component. So yeah, I reckon these two wires are just giving a pulse back to the computer on the bike. So basically it's just counting revs. So I guess if you've got the thing calibrated for the lowest ride height, for example, then you note that position, and then just count the number of revs of the armature up to the next ride height setting, and so on. So yeah, nice and straightforward, but it does need calibrating. There's no absolute idea of where the where this jack is. Yeah, this gear is indeed, oops, I don't know if you can see it, but you can see the blue gear inside there, so it's obviously this blue material is used for the entire gear. Runs very smoothly. It's obviously greased with something. So yeah, again, nice and straightforward. It's probably nylon, I would guess, maybe glass fill perhaps, but probably no need. And as I say, just pop rooted together. Cool. nice oil light, permanently lubricated, or once lubricated, bearing in the bottom there, all sealed up around this end. So yeah, straightforward. This O-ring, by the way, just seems to be a buffer against the back plate when all this is mounted on the suspension unit. I say it's not actually screwed to anything rigidly, it just sits on the shaft and is relatively loose, so this could bump, or it would bump against the aluminium plate. So yeah, that'll be set on there. And so it is loose in effect, so it would be knocking against there if it weren't for this O-ring. So very simple but effective, just stick an O-ring on there and pop your uncle. And meanwhile, this stays compliant enough not to bind up on the shaft. Yep, good stuff. So looking at this jack, this is actually a piston. I thought it was some kind of mechanical cam type arrangement, or a ramp, but it is actually hydronic, which is astonishing to me. But, there we go. So, O-ring and effectively a piston, even though it's got a big hole in the middle. Yeah, so there's an O-ring there. Which has come out of the top here. There's an O-ring that I've already taken out from the inside. So essentially, say this is a piston, because there's the main tube with a damper. So that will seal against this surface with the O-ring, and the outer surface, obviously, surface fits in here and seals on there. So all told, the whole lot seals, and there is a small hole, if you can see that, where oil can get in from the this side, and the oil filling hole. I've already taken the plug out of there, but it had a blue coloured oil in it as opposed to the red oil that was in the main damper. So the next thing is to see what's inside here. This plug here, did it seem to be a screw, but it, as soon as I put an Allen key in it, it just kind of stripped the hex canal. So I think I have to drill that out. I'll give it a try now. I'll use a left-hand drill, see whether that pulls the screw out. So this unscrews. So you can also need some kind of special tool here, looks like. So some kind of special tool to unscrew this properly. I've just grabbed it on the edge with the vise. Ooh, gosh. And then here, oop. Okay. Yeah, so this is a thrust washer. Sorry, thrust bearing. Very nice. With with a nice hard washer for it to work against, and then obviously the plug, which is also steel, I think. It could be alloy, but it's alloy. Okay, so that's obviously fixed to the jack itself. So as this rotates, it can push this element here forwards. Ah, so that thing I drilled out is just a pin to locate that and stop it rotating. It's just this milled groove to keep this thing orientated, or oriented correctly. What I don't quite get is how this seals. Looking down here, there's a bore, two bores, and it looks as if the far one is smaller and higher finished than this section up here. So about there, in fact, where the casting changes. This section is small diameter, finely machined bore, and this end is larger diameter and less carefully machined. Okay, so I've managed to get it out finally. So here's the piston with its O-ring seal. Just wondering why it's got this washer on it. Is that some kind of valve? Can't be. Yeah, that's all solid, that side, so there's no passageway through. So I guess that must just be a buffer for hitting the end of the cylinder. Yeah, that would work. Right, so where's the washer gun? There we go. So this is washer here. That fits on there. So it looks like that isn't actually attached. It's just the weight of the bike is going to be pushing this up. And there's no room for it to go, so they can't really get misaligned. Yeah, obviously that just sits there. So yeah, basically the whole of the rear of the bike is hanging on or supported by a column of oil. And the seal here and the seals around the top of the strut. That surprises me. In which case this whole effect sensor on here, I guess it's not, it could be counting revs, I suppose. Yeah, it could still be counting revs to get the different positions. There again, this could just be checking the motor's running at all, and this measuring the speed. Because of course there is the ride height sensor on the front and rear of the bike, so that's got to play a role in the way the computer chooses to run these things. Anyway, I guess a positive movement. Rotating this so many turns will give a fixed volume of oil being pushed through into the suspension and pushing this down. So yeah, well there you go, that's how the rear strut works.